sarvamangalamangalye shive sarvarta sadike sharanye trembake gauri narayani namostute. On the second day of Navratri, we discuss the appearance of Ma Durga in that beautiful form called Ashtadash Bhujaru. Mahishasur took birth, the demon, and of course, he took charge of all the various worlds. He created havoc, even for Vishnu and Shivji, Indra, Vayu, Varun, Kubir, all of them suffered some sort of torment. Troubles in life are not only limited to human beings. Disasters, when we stumble upon something, it is not limited to the creation of God. Even the deities, even those who have occupied spaces to bless us, even they, of course, they have to experience troubles so that they know what we go through. Mahishasura, of course, went and took charge of the abodes of Indra, of the heavens and earth as well. And this became very troubling for the deities. And when this happened, of course, no one could have conquered him because Mahishasura had the blessing, the bardan, the boon from Brahma, that no one, absolutely no one can defeat him unless that person is a woman. The deities got together, Bhagwan Vishnu called all of the devatas together, and they came up with a plan to create a form, an energy, a deity, a divine, a devi that is as powerful or more powerful than Mahishasura to overcome that challenge. Friends, whenever a demon presents itself in our life, and you know, demon is not something physical that we're looking for. I think many of us are facing or fighting demons in so many ways. The greatest demon sometimes is the self. We are fighting with the self, searching for our identity, searching for what we planned yesterday did not come through. We're struggling with so many things. In most cases, we are the greatest demon. Gita tells us we are the best friend and the worst enemy. When these demons come, we have to find ways to overcome them. As I've always told you, when the mountains come in our life, we should go to those mountains and tell them how great our God is, not the reverse. The devatas, they came together in unity. When we are united, even the weakest gets to contribute to something very powerful. All of them came together and they created the Devi, Ashtadash Bhujarup, with 18 arms. They all give the Devi different weapons. Bhagwan Shiva, of course, gives Trishul. Bhagwan Vishnu gives Sudarshan Chakra. But the one that struck me the most was when the Devi's eyes had to be created. When the Devi's eyes had to be created, Agni Bhagwan came, the god of fire. Agni, who we do our ahuti to, he appeared and he gave the Devi's Trinetra. She's described in the Devi Bhagavat as Trinetra Dhari, one with three eyes. The fiery, burning, yet compassionate eyes of the Devi. You know, in our West Indian tradition, we tell someone, you know, that your eyes catch fire on something. It either means that whatever you see you like, or you see somebody else's progress and you're jealous of it. Well, the Devi's eyes are fiery. And our scriptures tells us, my friends, that when we go to get the darshan of the Devi, we stand in front of her, no matter how tall we are reduced to nothing. Her fiery eyes burn us and reduce us to nothing. And that is what we are. In the Shaiva tradition, we are taught the greatest achievement we can have physically is when this body has become bhasma, vibhuti. When we have become, of course, the highest order of existence, that is nothing. Yes, the highest order of existence is nothing. And that is when Shivji takes us and rubs it on his body. Standing in front of the Devi with her fiery eyes does a couple of things. It reduces this big egoistic identity that we have created into nothing. And secondly, it purifies us. When we look into her eyes, our eyes become purified, our body becomes purified, our soul, of course, becomes purified. But it's not a once, you know, a year thing. We must do this, my friends, quite often. Agni Bhagwan gave the eyes to the Devi. Sandhya Devi gave the eyebrows. It is said that the eyelashes of the Devi were compared to strong arrows. as she was built as a very strong force, of course, to battle Mahishasura, the buffalo demon. Friends, the Devi, of course, tonight we discuss her appearance. And when she appeared, the Devatas ran to Bhagwan Vishnu and they said, Bhagwan Vishnu, tell us who she is. And the first thing Bhagwan Vishnu used to describe her might was that she's constant. The Devi, she's constant. Constant means she's not moved. You know, today you give her one lapsian puri, tomorrow you give her 20 or 200. She's constant. Today you're angry with her, tomorrow you're happy with her. She's constant. This is a quality that defines the Devi. This is a godly quality. And this is a quality that separates man from his maker. Because today, if it is raining or if it is snowing too hard or there's a disappointment in our life, what happens? We tend to, we tend to let life go. We tend to become sad. Tomorrow when there's a happy moment, yes, we're all happy again. Well, the thing is, loss, gains, trials and tribulations, she's always constant. It is a behavior that we must embrace and adapt in life. On the second day of Navaratri, we described the appearance of the goddess, trying to, of course, influence all of us to become one with her. Stand in front of her every day so that she can reduce you from what identity you've created to nothing. And remember, only and when you're nothing, only and when you have no identity, only and when there is a burning desire of love and devotion to always worship her, will she manifest herself in front of you. May all of us, of course, become pure. May we stay pure. And may Navaratri allow us to elevate and become one with the Devi. Jai Ma.